Hello, this is Chad with Syncfusion, and a customer has a question about using a tooltip with our grid control in Angular. Let's take a look. Here's the actual customer question. They want to display a tooltip, but the content of the cell is an object, not just some text. So let's look at a sample and show how we fix that. Here's my sample, and this is the data for the sample. If you look, there's simply an ID and then a collection of codes, key value pair. Here's the code behind this. A couple things to point out. Query cell info. This is conserved across, I think, every single grid Syncfusion makes. And the event is fired right before the cell is about to be drawn on the screen. So the cell knows everything it needs to make the pretty picture for you. It's also the very last chance you have to make any changes to that cell. So in this particular case, we are going to go through all the data, and then we're going to join. Then we're going to take this inner object. It's a span. I'll show you that in a minute. And we're going to join all these codes. And it looks like I added a little bit here. I added this for testing, and I forgot to remove it before I made this video. So there it is. And then this event here, this is the tooltip before the tooltip is rendered, before tooltip pops up, rather. It's going to pull out the data of the closest row, so we can get the data, parse it, and then add it into the data, and then add it into the grid, add it into the, display it in the tooltip. Okay, now here's the HTML, and I'm going to go ahead and show the sample at the same time. So if we look at this, we see a grid control here. And if I mouse over this little guy, I get a tooltip. And the tooltip is the data for that cell. Yes, Chad's not part of the data. It was added afterwards. So you can see it's actually doing what it should be doing. Now, how this is set up. If you look over here, you see the tooltip actually encapsulates the entire page. And the target for the tooltip is this thing right here, the codes icon, which is down here. This icon here is the codes icon. So that's a target. So when you mouse over the target, the tooltip's going to pop up. Now, what happens if I add something to this? I just kind of want to show exactly how this is working. So let's look at this, and I'm going to paste in some data here. So here I've added a new span inside the tooltip right here. I've added a span inside the tooltip, and I've added a span outside the tooltip. So let's add to our target here, this span, and I'm going to add the grid as well. So there's two targets, two names, the test, which is here, and the grid. And the grid is added right here. Here's the ID for the grid. So now when I mouse over this, I'm going to get a tooltip. But the tooltip is empty because the tooltip, the before open event, didn't find any rows, so it didn't find any data. If I come up here and I create the tooltip, now the tooltip has data. As I go over the grid, tooltip pops up for the grid. Tooltip pops up for this span, and there's nothing for this one. This one is outside of the tooltip. So that's it. We answered the question. It was just that easy. And thank you for watching.